All right, I'm the God of War. Gonix. Back of the house, Stag. Put a lamp on in a minute.
Familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Don't I quite agree? Unless, perhaps,
if it's something yet to be.
It is said, when Jormungandr and Skull are battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
Yeah. Thief's testimony. Where is it?
Oh.
No, what do you want in here? Don't worry about that one.
Betrayal to me.
Oh, yeah.
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And
their army, they're supposed to do him in the end.
But more than that, he covets their gifts and prophecies.
He wants to know what they know and see what they see.
So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah. Remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hand.
Oh, yeah. I can translate this now. Nephi, land of fog and fortune. Hey, nobody mentioned fortune. We should go there sometime. Ah, I can read what this says now. But it's a name. Rota! The name made it light up!
The name of one of the Valkyries. That's curious.
With my right one, I think it's starting to go. Off doing that. Off. I think my right stick's going. Oh, for fuck's sake, what's going on with this? Imagine that. No. Nah. for fuck's sake! What's going on with my camera fucking stick?
Saying something about love and hate being
intertwined, yes. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they hate. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great ones.
So Thor's half-god
and half-giant? Weird. Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed. And as war with Fannir raged, he could see what he really wanted. After no small amount of convincing, they agreed. For a while there, he belated on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes I could scarcely recall them all. He smiled, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was his main path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Like, who's doing that?
Good
point.
other name.
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Wonder who wrote this. Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something right here.
Thank you.
enemies ahead!
Thank you.
Look here.
Yes, sir.
Another map. Great.
Hey, it's another brazier.
I suppose you wish to light it.
Can I?
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. Kvekia.
I don't believe it. Are you both alive?
Another spirit.
Yes, another spirit.
Yes.
I can't remember the last time I saw something walk these islands that wasn't dead or corrupted.
What do you mean?
The desolation child. Plagues this land, growing more severe with each passing winter.
Do you know its cause?
Not for certain, but I suspect the appearance of the world serpent, along with the great flood that followed. Many were drowned, myself among them. The dead began to walk not long after.
Do you need anything from us?
Boy.
Boy.
I only wish to speak to someone again. A wish you have just granted. Thank you.
Correct.
Can't we
this
just...
is not a debate. You must learn focus. Our journey need no concern.
But what if they can help us? That one seemed to know a little about the lake.
And how does that help us with our goal?
We won't know unless we ask. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Fran get the hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough.
Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Oh! Another name.
Someone who loved a Valkyrie is enough to do this. I wonder, perhaps the Queen?
There
was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, and victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr. Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word and his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Checking it out. Was there more? Let me think. There's an abandoned temple in Midgard that a fellow dwarf converted to his personal storeroom. Packed it with all sorts of treasures he collected during his travels throughout the realms.
Throughout the realms? Which ones did he go to? What did he collect?
Fafnir was a, shall we say, aggressive collector of magical artifacts. The more he acquired, the more he desired. There was no realm too dangerous, no relic too hazardous. He once ventured deep into Niflheim for a whetstone, of all things. Huh. I bet that was quite the whetstone.
Does the story have a point?
Yes, it does. I just happened to have an entry stone to Fafnir's storeroom. You might find something useful in there.
Neat. Thanks, Sindri.
You're very welcome. Oh, and if you find that whetstone, well, it sure would be nice of you to bring it to me. I'd advise caution if you're heading to the storeroom. Last I was there, all manner of nastiness had taken up residence.
Won't your friend be upset if you steal all the stuff?
No, not at all. He's...
Oh, sorry.
No, don't be sorry. These things happen when one travels from realm to realm collecting priceless artifacts.
Another entrance.
Betray it to me.
I see something up there.
Here, boy.
Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here. Looks like the Reavers made it inside. I hope they didn't take all the treasure.
Exactly.
Go!
resources. The main reason we are here, boy. However, many of these chests have been emptied.
I'll be right with you. I hope they didn't take Sidious Whetstone.
About expectations, boy.
Keep them low. I remember. Good feeling.
I saw.
So I should keep my expectations low, but always expect an attack?
It is a delicate balance. Expect the worst, assume nothing, and always anticipate an attack.
Sure is a lot to remember.
Thank you.
Back to piss on my corpse, you ungrateful little...
Who are you, so?
Have you seen it?
Aye, there was one in this room. My son sharpened his dagger on it, right before stabbing me in the back.
What?
Little bastard thought it was his turn to lead my crew. I was hard on him, sure. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. I did the same thing to my dad when I was his age.
He killed his own father?
Where is he now?
He may be a bastard, but he's my bastard.
You'll get no help,
you'll get
from,
no
me,
help from me, fool.
Then his dagger will
help.
Hey! That's mine! Hey!
No, come on now.
We are leaving.
Well, what did you think of Fafnir's storeroom?
We found no whetstone. This dagger belongs in the reroom.
I took most of the good stuff.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? Well, here, take this. In exchange for the dagger. Hmm. dagger you brought me is quite interesting. An artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In Ariora's back.
Oh.
Oh. Imagine he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the wood stone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before. I have a favor to ask. Just a small favor, really.
Let's get started then.
Anything you need, sir?
What did we miss?
You don't need to make excuses to say hello.
Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah, I haven't forgotten that one.
Well, I traced it to a group of Reavers that operate out of the Northrend stronghold. I'd wager that's where they took their haul from Fafnir's storeroom, along with that whetstone that I could use to help you.
Why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to be a career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cool piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they call us. Never spite till the last. Get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of all the mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. And one day he was not amused. And I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads traveled since then turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
We can talk about here.
Thank you.
Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't know how much else going on right now. I'm feeling creative today. Well, when you do need something...
The travelers.
Whoa, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes? Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all. And what do you have your eye on? Seeing ya. Come in. Well, scramble around a bit more and we'll build something.
It's a fucking round steak.
I don't suppose you can try keeping that clean. Was there more? Let me think.
still can't believe his son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, we only got one side of the story. But come on! His own father? I mean, I get angry at you sometimes.
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I'd never stab you in the back.
No. But...
this clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water.
My thought as well.
Formidable duo!
What?
With me. When?
Oh. I guess... sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can't.
It is not always easy to know what...
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that one stone I want? I wish Mom were here.
Thank you.
This is Sun.
That ghost son? How do you know?
Sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's bag. He stood his ground, but it was not enough. They betrayed him.
Betrayal.
Yes, murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others. Thought himself unfortunately. It cost him his life. I guess.
Look there, lad, by his feet.
The whetstone.
Yes, they used it to smash his face in.
They did? Yeah.
Look here.
This is it.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We found our way down.
Oh, wonderful!
This thing is amazing.
Smashing out of our spaces.
Oh, wonderful. Here, for your trouble. I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look like much, but it's practically humming with magic. I've needed a new one after my brother about the last one. Hello, man! He said. I didn't ask for it.
He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the world tree of its secrets. Until I think quite rightly, he got fed up with him and sent him back to the land of the living. I don't mention he was barking mad.
Since you brought that out here.
better than ever. You know, I really think we've both grown in our years apart.
So how come you're back here?
Just catching some fresh air. Look, I love my brother, but he still smells like a fetid dung pile.
Sindri, have you always been so
clean? Huh, don't I wish. No, I was just as unsanitary as the next dwarf until the day a Vanir witch set me straight. She discovered with her magic there are hundreds of thousands of tiny beasties on everything around us. Oh, so small you can't even see them.
No.
It's true. And if they get inside you, they make you sick. But the witch told me there's one wood, the oak, that's a natural deterrent. Stops the beasties from spreading. So now, I make all my handles from oak. See? I look at these things. Okay, back to work.
What are you fools doing back here? Come to pilfer my boots and small clothes.
We found your son. He was betrayed too. And we found part of his journal. It sounded like you regretted killing him.
Fat lot of good that does me. How'd he go out? He died fighting?
We found four corpses near his. They were decapitated.
Ha! Vandrid always did keep his sword nice and sharp. A lesson he picked up from me.
He's a backstabbing bastard, but no one he's in Valhalla sets me at ease. Thanks.
We did a good thing. I'm glad we came back here.
That thief did not deserve the peace he gave him.
Maybe so. Still, it feels good to help people. Even the devil.
So much like your mother. Why?
Oh, it's fine. Very good question, actually. You see, my brother's not as careful as I am. In fact, he prefers to work with metals using his own bare hands. Ugh. No gloves, since it's the only way he can hear what it wants to be. Touch enough muscle and change your skin directly. I wouldn't bring it up to him, though. You know how sensitive.
I guess that makes sense.
And have a look. Look at the way the pavement merges into the road. And the idea is it gives pedestrians and cyclists a sense of freedom to move around the space.
Atreus, follow me.
How'd you come to be in these lands?
Lad, there comes a time in every man's life when he changes his name and heads north to make a new start. If you live long enough to do this many times over, you might end up as far north as this place. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation, and so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value, a mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushrooms to make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on. But the day he took my eye, I realized he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him, called the lesson wisdom, and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.